As Pharaoh drew closer, the Israelites looked back and saw the Egyptians coming toward them. They were terrified and cried to God. They said to Moses, "Weren't there enough graves in Egypt that you took us away to die in the desert?" But Moses said to the people, "Do not be afraid. Stand your ground and watch God rescue you today. The Egyptians you see today will never ever see again." Then God said to Moses, "Why do you cry out? Tell the Israelites to get moving. Lift your shepherd's rod. Stretch out your hand over the sea and split it in two, so that the Israelites can go into the sea on dry ground. I'll make the Egyptians stubborn, so they will go in after them, and I'll gain the honor at the expense of the Pharaoh, all his army, chariots and cavalry. The Egyptians will know that I am God." God's messenger, who had been in front of the Israelites' camp, moved and went behind them. The column of cloud stood between Egypt's camp and Israel's camp, and when darkness fell, it lit up the night. They didn't come near each other all night. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea. God pushed the sea back by a strong east wind, all night turning the sea into dry land. The waters were split into two. The Israelites walked into the sea on dry ground. The waters formed a well for them on their right and on their left. The Egyptians chased them and went to the sea after them. God threw the Egyptians' camp into a panic. They said, "Let us away from the Israelites, because their God is fighting for them against Egypt." God said to Moses, "Stretch out your hand so the water comes back and covers the Egyptians, their chariots and their cavalry." At daybreak, the sea turned to its normal depth and covered Pharaoh's entire army that had followed them into the sea. God rescued Israel from the Egyptians that day. The people were in awe of God. They believed in God and God's servant Moses. Then the prophet Miriam, Aaron's sister, took a tambourine in her hand. Miriam sang, "Sing to God for an overflowing victory. Horse and rider have been thrown into the sea."
The divine hand came upon me, and God brought me out by the Spirit and set me down in the middle of a valley. It was full of bones. God led me all around them. There were very many lying in the valley. God said, "Mortal, can these bones live?" I answered, "God, you know." Then God said to me, "Prophesy to these bones and say to them, 'O dry bones, hear God's word.' Thus says God to these bones, 'I will cause breath to enter you and you shall live. I will lay sinews on you and cause flesh to come upon you and cover you with skin and put breath in you, and you shall live, and you shall know that I am God.'" So I prophesied as I had been commanded. And as I prophesied, suddenly there was a noise, a rattling, and the bones came together. I looked, and there were sinews on them, and flesh, and skin covered them, but there was no breath in them. Then God said to me, "Prophesy to the breath, prophesy, mortal, and say to the breath, thus says God, come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe upon these slain that they may live." I prophesied as I was commanded, and the breath came into them, and they lived and stood on their feet, a vast multitude. God said to me, "Mortal, these bones are the whole house of Israel. They say our bones are dried up and our hope is lost. Therefore, prophesy and say to them, thus says the Lord, I am going to open your graves and bring you up from your graves, O my people. And I will bring you back to the land of Israel. And you shall know that I am God when I open your graves and bring you up from them. I will put my spirit within you, and you shall live."
Thus says the God of hosts, "See, the day is coming, burning like an oven, when the arrogant and evildoers will be stubble, and they will not be left with neither root nor branch. But for all who revere my name, the Son of Righteousness shall rise with healing in its wings."
Do you not know that all of us who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? Therefore, we were buried with him by baptism into death, so that, just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of God, we also might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we will certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. We know that our old self was crucified with him so that the body of sin might be destroyed and we are no longer enslaved to sin. If we died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. We know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. He now lives to God. So you must also consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Christ Jesus.
Invite you to remain standing. Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran, and she went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken away the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." Then Peter and the other disciple set out for the tomb. The disciple whom Jesus loved reached the tomb, bent down, looked in, and saw the linen wrappings lying there. Then Simon Peter went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head rolled up by itself. The other disciple went in. He saw and believed. Until then, they did not understand the scripture, how he must rise from the dead.
Please be seated. We gather on this night, this holy night, before the lilies are placed, before the Easter brunches or lunches, and before the flowered crosses with the coming dawn. This is the night when a new world was born. A night when we feel the overwhelming embrace of God's love. We gather in old ways, or perhaps in new ways, holding vigil and celebrating Easter. We gather as people of faith, as people of faith have for almost 2,000 years, and we gathered in darkness, the darkness of night, the dimness that still continued from Good Friday. We gather with a fire, we light candles, we hear the stories of our faith that remind us of our place in this faith. We sing and we pray. We welcome new siblings of faith through baptism, and we share in our holy meal of communion. We come together for this opportunity to proclaim the mystery of our faith. Christ has died, Christ has risen, Christ will come again. We proclaim This is the night. This is the night when we stand in the liminal space and find ourselves at the profound paradox that holds life's greatest promises. We are drawn to this candle. We are drawing our attention to Christ and the light, the focal point of the stories we shared aloud, of how over and over again our God creates order out of chaos, liberation out of oppression, hope out of despair, and life out of death. These stories all culminate in the one that finds Mary Magdalene early in the morning while it is still dark at an empty tomb. She invites Simon Peter and the other disciple to enter the tomb. And only upon witnessing this empty space did they fully understand that this was the night Jesus had risen in the fulfillment of his teachings to them. This is the night that we have the profound opportunity to proclaim the good news and connect our story once again with God's story. We recall that death does not have the last word, for our story can never be seen as separate from God's story. From the moment we are formed in the womb, God is with us. Our stories have been dancing with one another in a fantastic waltz of love. So as Christians, we often talk of Easter about a time of light, more specifically to see the light overcoming the darkness of Good Friday, to pit one against the other. But I think that this is to miss the way that God is working and present in both the light and the dark. In her book, Learning to Walk in the Dark, Barbara Brown Taylor writes, "Resurrection is always announced with Easter lilies, the sound of trumpets, bright streaming light. But it did not happen that way. It happened in a cave. It happened in complete silence, in absolute darkness, with the small damp stone and the dung earth in the air. New life starts in the dark, whether it is a seed in the ground, a baby in the womb, or Jesus in the tomb. It starts in the dark." So tonight, let us open our minds and embrace the darkness. Let us move away from a tendency to think of the darkness as places of despair or confusion, times when God feels far away. But let us embrace the goodness in the darkness, the goodness that Simon Peter and the other disciple found in that tomb. I want you to think for a moment, what are some blessings that come to us in the darkness? In the dark and in the quiet of the evening, we can rest and replenish. In the dark and in the quiet of the earth, bulbs wait for the warming temperatures of spring. In the dark and in the quiet, seeds germinate before pushing green shoots up above the soil, ready for sun. God works marvelous wonders amidst the darkness. As the words of Psalm 139 remind us, darkness is not dark to you. The night is as bright as the day. Darkness and light are both alike, for you have created my innermost parts. You knit me together in my mother's womb. God creates in the darkness on the first day of Genesis and today in the soil, in the cave. God embraces the darkness as a place with respect and the beginnings of growth. And so God invites us tonight to meet in the tomb with Simon Peter, Mary Magdalene, and the other disciple. There we will find belief, just like they did, belief in God. God is with us in the tomb, just as God is there with us at our baptism, at our confirmations, at the table for communion, and here tonight when we gather in community. God's great love for us is a story that never ends. Even when we may feel alone or disconnected, when we may feel like God is far away, God's sign of reconciliation is marked in his love for us always. So on that holy night so long ago, a vigil was kept, but the work of resurrection and new life was taking place. And so the same is true for us tonight. This is the night. This is the night when we are reminded that God has not brought us this far in faith to ever leave us. The joy of the Easter is grounded in knowing that God is always with us. God opens the path to walk in newness of life together, whether that is in the dark and the quiet, in the unknown, or in the bright and joyful. And so, God, on this holy night, that shines with the glory of resurrection, let us give thanks for the dark and the quiet, amidst the light and the fanfare of tomorrow, and in the moments in the in-between, knowing that God's steady presence is always creating, inviting, and restoring. We gather and we bear witness to the fullness of this truth. And when it comes time to go forth from here sharing what we have seen, may we follow in the footsteps of those of faith who have gone before us, Mary Magdalene, Simon Peter, and the other disciples, telling the good news, with our fears cushioned by great joy in the knowledge of God's wondrous works. May we remember that this is the night. This is the night when our story is connected with God's story forevermore. Amen.
And so in the company of Simon Peter and Mary Magdalene and all the other disciples who have ever come before us, we celebrate tonight God's gift of grace given to us in the sacrament of baptism, affirming how by water and the Spirit we are called, claimed, commissioned, called God's own, affirmed as children of God, claimed by Christ to share in his life through his resurrection, and so to be commissioned to Christ's ministry of love, peace, and justice.
On behalf of the congregation of St. James United Church, here with the members of United Churches from across our community, I present Hawa Abdul Azzi for initiation into the body of Christ through baptism.
As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way and to shall wear, starting show me the way. Oh, sisters, let's go down, come on down. Oh, sisters, let's go down, down in the river to pray.
Hawa, over the last several months, you have been engaged in a time of study and prayer, readying yourself for this night. Before we celebrate this sacrament of rebirth, I ask you, do you believe in God, our divine parent who has created and is creating? And in Jesus, the Word made flesh, who came to reconcile and make new. And in the Holy Spirit, who continually works in us and others. And desiring the freedom of new life in Christ, will you seek to resist evil and so proclaim Jesus crucified and risen in all that you say and do? And will you join with your siblings in this community of faith and communities of faith across our region to celebrate God's presence, live with respect in creation, and love and serve others?
You have heard the will of Ahava to be received into the household of faith as you were also received. Will you support her with love, example, mentorship, and prayer?
We will, God being our helper. Then let us now rise as we give thanks for the gift of water through which we are all made new in Christ. Gracious and holy God, we bless you for the gift of life and within it the gift of water. Over its unshaped promise, your Spirit hovered at creation, making it the wellspring of all life. Through water, you led the children of Israel out of bondage and into freedom. And in the waters of the Jordan, Jesus was baptized, where you claimed him as your beloved child, an affirmation shared with all people, that we may receive the breath of your Spirit and so live. May that same Spirit breathe now upon this water and what we do here, that all who draw near may not only die with Christ, but rise with Christ into new and everlasting life. In his name we pray. Amen. And so, Hawa, we baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Okay. And I think a big towel around her. Wait. Awesome. And so now Howa is going to get dry and return for the laying out of hands. But in the meantime, my friends, you have been witness of the life-giving power of this sacrament as our fellow seeker, now a sister in Christ. As her siblings, I invite you to renew the promises of your baptism. Hold on to your stones, the stones of the tomb that was rolled away, and prepare now to release them into the water as your sign of your own prayer for rebirth. So I ask you, do you believe in God who has created and is creating? Oh, I'm sorry. Do you believe in God? We believe in God who has created and is creating, who has come in Jesus, the Word made flesh, to reconcile and make new, and who works in us and others by the Spirit. Will you follow in the way of Jesus, rolling away the stones of dead living As you live with respect for creation, love and serve others, seek justice, resist evil, proclaim Jesus who was crucified and risen. I will, by God's grace, will you join with others to live into the life-giving power of God's reign, trusting that we are not alone, but that God is with us. I will, by God's grace. So, my friends, my beloved, come to the water and renew your baptism. You may drop your stone in as you come. Do whatever you wish at the water. Splash each other even if you must. Or splash me. Anyone who needs not to kneel, you can come to the bowl.
Thank you.
I invite you to rise as we pray for the Spirit to be enlivened even more in Hawa. And friends, lay hands with me. By the sign of your Christ and the gift of your Spirit, O God, strengthen Hawa that she may be true to you all her life long. Amen.
Hawa, receive this Bible and hear what the Spirit is saying to you and the church.
And so into the household of faith, we welcome you, Hawa, as members of the body of Christ and inheritors of God's promise. We welcome you with thanksgiving, with love, and with joy. So friends, as we said at the beginning of the service, the offering for today is for Stella's Circle in support of all the amazing, amazing programs that they do. And so as our gifts are brought forward, we will sing, "Let us talents and tongues employ," and we will also be preparing the table for our feast. Let us pray. God, our strength and salvation, receive all we offer you today. May we who have professed Christ's resurrection and shared in the faith of our baptism continue to live in the joy of risen life. In the name of the risen one, we pray. Amen. Amen. Friends, after Jesus' death, his friends experienced the unexpected. The one who taught, challenged, loved them was in their midst. Whenever they shared a meal, they remembered him, and he was with them. Tonight, as we break bread and as we share wine, we do the same. And as we remember him, he is risen amongst us as well. You may be seated. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Open your hearts. We open them to God. Let us give thanks. It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right to praise you, living God, Creator of heaven and earth.
You formed us in your image and breathed into us your holy breath, calling us to be your children. And though at times we forgot that call and wandered away from you, you remained steadfast. Again and again, you restored your people, calling them to be a blessing to the nations. Grateful for this abiding love, we join your angels in a song of praise.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in God's name. Hosanna in the highest.
We praise and thank you, redeeming God, for your Son, Jesus Christ. You affirmed him as your child and through his death and resurrection gave birth to your church. Called to embody his love in the world, we remember how on the night before Jesus died, he took bread, and after giving you thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body given for you."
In the same way, he took the cup, saying, "Take, drink, this is a sign of the new covenant in my lifeblood. Whenever you eat and drink, remember me." We do remember, sustaining God, grateful on this day, we experience in the inbreaking of your kingdom, your new life revealed in resurrection. Let us proclaim the mystery of our faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We pray, gracious God, that you fill us with your Spirit, present here with us and these gifts of bread and wine. May all who share this living bread and saving cup be renewed in your grace and affirmed in your love, sharing what it means to be your children, a blessing to the nations. Through Christ, with Christ, in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory is yours, holy God, now and forever. Amen. My friends, as we prepare to share in this feast of resurrection, let us do so praying that the whole heavenly reign of God, who is mother and father to us all, be made known here and now in all that we say and do. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. This is the bread of life Christ shared in hope for the world.
This is the fruit of the vine, Christ shared in the spirit of peace and joy.
This is the banquet of blessing, Christ inviting everyone in love.
Thanks be to God. So, my friends, we are celebrating in a true intinction fashion this evening, which means come on forward. We will give you bread. It's an unleavened pita bread. Equally so, there is a gluten-free option here for you. But then rather than go and getting a little teeny itty-bitty glass, there is a lovely cup here. And so just dip your bread in and consume and then head back to your spot. So, friends, come. The banquet is ready. If there's anybody who needs us to come to you, please raise a hand. Let us pray together. Holy God, here at this table, we tasted your promise of new life and welcomed you into our lives. Strengthened by this gift, send us to proclaim your resurrection, to live in the grace of your renewing love. In Jesus we pray. Amen. So we will soon be going forth into the world to share risen life with all. And we are singing words that we will most likely all be singing tomorrow as we gather again in community. But here in this place, this is the most important time to sing it. Christ the Lord is risen today.
Christ the Lord is risen today. Amen.
risen with Christ. We know the reassurance of God's presence. Risen with Christ, we accept the challenge to walk in God's way. Risen with Christ, we are proof that God's life will never die. So go now in joy. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia.